How are we doing, ladies and gentlemen? It's Nex from Gamer Theories, and it's time to get my Game of Thrones off-season up and running with my first Season 8 theory. We'll be going over the history of the Bravosi Institute, taking a closer look at their involvement in Season 7, and seeing what their role is going to be in Season 8, as I believe we will finally see the rise of the Iron Bank in Westeros. I want to say a huge thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Make sure you stick around until the end, as I will be talking a bit about my new site that I'm creating with their help. Alright, let's get started with today's theory. The Iron Bank will have its due. These are not the words strung together by a noble house attempting to strike fear in their enemies or some manufactured motto. This is a famous saying quoted by all people in the known world who are aware of the Bravosi Bank's reputation, a reputation that has manifested due to the organization's ruthless methods when dealing with people who owe them money. They've been talked about since the beginning of Season 1, and we've even seen them a handful of times, but only to seemingly give their money away to fallen kings or entertain the outrageous debts of the capital, hardly living up to their dangerous reputation. Before Season 7 aired, I spoke with many people about how I think they could have a larger role to play in the overall story, perhaps even gunning for the capital or one of the throne's successors in an attempt to reclaim their gold. After all, that is their trade by name. But it seems like almost everyone I talked to disagreed, and that the Iron Bank is simply the Iron Bank. However, now that Season 7 has finished, not only were we given more content and screen time with the Iron Bank, but it's also been confirmed that they will be coming back for Season 8. So, let me ask the same questions I did before Season 7 even started. If the Iron Bank is only going to be purposed as a dog's body for funding the capital of Westeros, then why would you even bother giving them any of the precious little screen time remaining? Why build this worldwide known reputation of them being a company you simply don't screw with? And why have them delivering sinister absolutes to Queen Cersei at this stage in the game if they're not going to amount to anything? Logically, it doesn't make sense, and my answer to those questions is because the Iron Bank has a monumental part to play before we reach the end of this story. So, let's go through the scenes that they were involved in during Season 7 and some of the other contributing events that greatly influence what role they could play, as I think we were given the biggest Easter egg possible as to what is going to happen. During the episode, The Queen's Justice, the Crown perfectly executed an ingenious plan. Cersei tricked Tyrion into thinking they would defend their beloved home of Casterly Rock, but instead, she had Jaime mount an attack on Highgarden. Not only did this move ensure that they extinguished one of Daenerys' allies, but they were also able to plunder the Tyrells' gold to help with their debts to the Iron Bank. We know the gold safely made its way through to King's Landing, but only at a great cost, as it resulted in the loss of many Lannister troops, and their allies, the Tarleys, were completely destroyed. The fact that the gold was recovered is insanely significant, because in one of the meetings held between Cersei and Tycho, he specifically states that they will support the crown, but only once the gold arrives. However, due to some of the recent events, this could change the Iron Bank's position on whether they'll be funding the capital. As things stand, if Daenerys wanted to, she could storm King's Landing with her Unsullied, her Dothraki, two dragons, and take the Seven Kingdoms. There is of course also the Night King, his newly acquired dragon, and his horde of undead soldiers that are looking more unstoppable with every episode. Let's be honest, this is not looking like a solid investment for the Bravosi Bank to be making, and if they can't see that, then I'm quite frankly confused about how they even managed to acquire such wealth or gain a notorious reputation. Regardless of this, Cersei has sent Euron off to Essos to spend the gold on hiring the Golden Company, a sellsword army, and bring them back to Westeros. Some 20,000 troops. But nonetheless, they are a sellsword army, which means once there is no more gold, they're gone. Has the Iron Bank really funded this move? Let's look at the facts. We have 6 episodes left. The Iron Bank are set to make a return in season 8, and so far, we have not actually seen them confirm whether they support this move to buy the Golden Company. Let's assume that they did give Cersei the go-ahead. She's already stated that she won't be helping the North in their fight against the Night King, so what screen time would the Iron Bank need here? If the North win, there isn't much time for more wars with the capital, and if the North don't win, 20,000 troops won't be stopping the Night King. So again, what is the role going to be of the Iron Bank? Well, let's say for one moment that the Iron Bank doesn't support the move to buy the Golden Company. Do you really see Cersei just handing over the gold and leaving herself defenseless? Of course she wouldn't, and I'm almost certain that this is exactly what's happened. Golden Company or not, there is no positive situation here or solid foundation for the Iron Bank to invest in. It's just another Stannis Baratheon situation. What if Cersei has betrayed the Iron Bank by spending the promised gold without their permission, and we finally get to witness what we've been told throughout this entire story, that the Iron Bank will have its due? In fact, what if this line, spoken by Tycho himself, was a huge Easter egg for precisely just that?
Indeed, but sometimes tragedies are necessary to restore order and rational leadership.
Sometimes tragedies are necessary to restore order and rational leadership? Not only could this be a major throwback to the huge rumour that the Iron Bank was responsible for the Doom of Valyria, a tragedy that restored order to Essos and provided rational leadership to each of its 3 cities, but what if this was a threat? He stated how they have used the Golden Company to recover outstanding debts before. So what if Euron and Cersei are walking into a trap, and them bringing the Golden Company back to Essos is a double-edged play by the Iron Bank to recover their gold? We've seen in Daenerys' visions that King's Landing will be destroyed. Is this the aftermath of the Night King, or will the Iron Bank have its due and show their true destructive power? Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the theory. Let me know your thoughts about the future role of the Iron Bank in the comments below. Earlier, I mentioned the new site that I was creating with the help of Squarespace.com. If you've never heard of them before, they are one of the best user-friendly and intuitive website development tools that you will ever come across. Thanks to their amazing selection of carefully designed templates, I was able to get my site off the ground within a matter of minutes. Honestly, if you've ever thought about making your own website, then you should definitely use them. Just go to squarespace.com/gameoftheories. They're currently offering a free 14-day trial. They have dozens of templates that are specifically designed for different categories, such as music, food, fashion, and photography. And right now, they're offering my viewers 10% off your first purchase. Simply click on the link at the top of the description or go to squarespace.com/gameoftheories and get building your very own online platform. Alright, I'll be back next Thursday with a brand new video and a brand new theory. So until then, 7 blessings to you all, and I'll see you guys next week.